Hey, everybody. I'm so grateful for this opportunity to talk to you today about a topic that is so important in leadership. And what that is that's diversity and inclusion. And so often and then not, this doesn't get taught, and our full leadership potential cannot be met. All right, so here we go. Let's begin. This is an introduction. If we've never met, just a quick introduction. I'm Mr. Chow. Nice to meet you. I'm a high school and teacher and college professor, and I'm passionate about training up our next generation of student leaders. I'm running a summer leadership academy right now, every single morning with about 60 students. And because there's been such a demand from our online audience, I've been recording our a quick summary of each day and posting it on YouTube so you too can participate with us. If you like this content, please consider staying with us over the next 2 weeks. We have so much more to learn together, and I truly hope that you can get something out of this content. So please go ahead and subscribe. And if you like this, give it a thumbs up. All right, here we go. Our academy vision is very simple. It's a 4-week summer leadership academy. And this week, once again, we're focusing all on diversity and inclusion. Not only is it a hot topic, it's something all leaders should be aware of as they take control of a team or of an organization. Okay. Why are we talking about this? Because the US is becoming one of the most diverse nations in the world. And we need to learn how to work with and lead many different people in our career and life. And it's important for us to talk about how to do that. So I want to be really practical today on how you can get some good skills and some good tips on how to do that. You know, once again, today's goal, how can you be a better leader in a changing world? What is diversity? What is inclusion? What is equity versus equality? And the impact of mental models in leadership. I want to be very clear that there's no personal agenda in this presentation. I'm not going to push anything. I'm not going to talk about critical race theory or any of that stuff. I just want to get super, super clear on student leaders. How can you better serve the people you work with? Who come from a different background. Okay, here we go. Let's get it going. So some good advice and practice that my students have been doing all academy long. Take some notes, right? Whatever is helpful to you, write it down and make sure you have a running list, because if you stay with us every day, there's so much information and I want you to get the most out of this. There's a free simple note taker in the Google Form link below. So if you haven't already, go ahead and click on that, give me your email, and I'll send you a free note taker that you can complete for a free certificate of completion. Let's begin. Always remember, everything you do, anything you put effort and time into, you're going to see results in. So I got to be honest, this past weekend, I spent 3 to 4 hours hearing podcasts and reading research articles from leading universities on diversity and inclusion. And I've learned so much. This isn't just for you, this is also for me in terms of what can I learn as a leader. So I'm so grateful to teach you some of the things that I've learned. So the first thing we did in our class today is we talked about, before I even covered it, what does diversity mean? What is inclusion? And what is equity? All right. So go ahead and think about that as we begin. And if you're taking notes here, diversity is a presence of difference. It's all the ways in which people differ within a given setting. Okay. So when you look out at a group, yeah, you can tell if they're diverse pretty quickly based on how they look. However, it goes beyond that. Diversity is also all the ways in which people differ: their upbringing, their culture, their language, their community, their history. All right. So that's what diversity is. So if I'm going too quick, go ahead and pause right there, and then we can go ahead and write that down. Okay. You don't have to write this one down, but in general, you can have, for example, a diverse species, a diversity of species within an ecosystem, a diversity of clothing brands, or a diversity of opinion or experiences. Going further, diversity is also identities, race, gender, and in some cases, ethnicity, religion, nationality, or sexual orientation. These are all examples of diversity. All right. Not just one of them, it's all of them put together. We talked about this in our call this morning. Why do you think diversity is important and the difference between race and ethnicity? Now, as a teacher, as a leader, I don't want to just assume that everyone knows what these terms are. That's why I'm going to define them. So many times when you ask students, "Hey, do you know what this is?" and they think about, "Have I seen this word?" "Oh, I have. Sure, I know what it is." But just to be clear, there's definitions for each of these words, and that's why we're going to go through them. Why is diversity important? We had a great discussion this morning. Diversity, though, we all come from different backgrounds, we're going to have so much more to bring to the table. We're going to have so much more value. We're going to have so many more perspectives. But so often than not, leaders understand that sometimes when we're too diverse, there's conflict. But I could argue that in any circumstance, in any leadership team, you're going to be different, even if you look the same, and you're going to have conflict. All right. So once again, I would rather have more people to bring different backgrounds together versus the opposite. Race describes physical traits. Go and write that down. Just a simple definition from dictionary.com. Ethnicity refers to cultural identification. When people ask me, what's your ethnicity? It's really tricky. I know what they're asking, but I also am thinking about my parents came from another country and I've never been to that country. And I was born in the US. So when I think of my culture, I don't just think about my heritage. I don't think about where my parents came from. I think about my upbringing, right? And everything that I've learned growing up. So that's what ethnicity is. It's cultural identification. See, you've got to understand that to be a diverse organization, all you need is a presence of differences, gender, male and female, right? Or others, and people of color. However, I love what this article goes on to say. It says how an organization can be diverse, but sometimes they are not inclusive. So in almost every video that I've watched, it pretty much said it's easy to get diversity. You just hire a bunch of different people who look different. However, to be inclusive, that's a little more tricky. We watched a video in our class this morning together, and it was titled Leadership Tips for Diversity and Inclusion. And it was from LinkedIn, which is a social media platform in which you can create a profile and let people know what your experiences are and your professional background is in. But here are some powerful lessons we got from that video. Diversity and inclusion in a company starts with what? It starts with great leadership. It starts from the top down. It needs to be a part of the fundamental core values of what a company believes in. There's a power in one-to-one meetings. If you want to get to know someone, you don't do it in a large setting. You do it in a small one-to-one meeting, but that takes time and that takes effort. So many times we don't have enough time and that doesn't get done. Next, what if you were the leader of the X-Men? And I love this analogy here because it pretty much explains everyone on the X-Men team comes from a diverse background and they all have a diverse group of skills. And if you don't utilize those skills, then really what you're missing out is those people being who they really are. So I love that whole analogy. What if you accidentally offend someone? How do you come back from that? And I love what this video had to share about that. And then finally, it finishes off with having an insane curiosity and how that can help you in the workplace. I'm not talking about, drilling someone and really getting to know them. No, it's about organically and effectively getting to know people for who they are and asking the right questions. So thanks for letting me share that, okay? Inclusion, let's go to write this down. Inclusion is all about folks being with different identities, feeling and or being valued, leveraged, or welcomed in a given setting. Just because you're diverse doesn't mean you're inclusive. Inclusiveness means that you're valued. Your powers, your talents are leveraged and you're welcomed in a given setting. That's really what we're going for in today's day and age. I love this quote from Verna Myers. Diversity is being asked to the party. Inclusion is being asked to dance. It's all about being included, valued, leveraged as a member of that organization or society. Okay. We did another breakout room. What's the benefit of working with people from a diverse group? And then we talked about why do you think people like working with people who look like them? And we talked about how when people look like you think that we're going to have the same beliefs and values. And sometimes we do. And so often than not, there's no conflict because of that. And that's something we always look for, like as humans, right? The path of least resistance. But just because it's the path of least resistance doesn't mean it's the best path. Probably not always. Okay. So keep that in mind. Then we had a discussion on equality versus equity. Equality being giving everyone the same resource, right? You see that? So just because it's the same bike, it doesn't mean that everyone's going to be best suited for that bike. Here is a larger person on the bike or a smaller person on the bike or a person who can't use their legs. Versus equity is all about giving people what they need to be successful. So in this example, this person right here can't move their legs, but they can move their arms and then they can also move as well, giving this person a bigger bike or a smaller bike. That's equity versus equality. You may have seen these examples here, right? Equality is giving everyone the same thing. Equity is giving you what you need to see over the fence. Now, we're not going to get into it. But I will ask you to think, as a leader, what are you doing for your people? And I get it. There's going to be backlash. Well, that's not fair. I understand that that's not fair, but as a leader, you need to think about your members. You need to think about, how are you serving your people? And ultimately, are you giving them the resources needed for them to participate and for them to be successful? Okay. Once again, equality, giving each person exactly the same resources. Equity, each person has different circumstances, different backgrounds, different upbringings, and allocating the exact resources and opportunities needed to reach an equal outcome. Pause it there if you want to write those down. It's super important for you to understand as a leader. Something else I got to have you think about is, so often than not, you look at a group of people who aren't doing well and you're like, they're lazy. We jump to conclusions, but those conclusions aren't always right. Sometimes these people who you're looking at, who you're stereotyping, who we stereotype, and even I do it sometimes too, they don't have the same upbringing as you. They may not have had the same resources, had the same parent help, et cetera, or opportunities. So once again, it's really understanding these two principles as a leader that's going to help you lead your people. I'll finish off with this. I did something called mental models in my class, and I'm not going to do it fully here because we can't, because we're not all live here in person, but I did this in a previous TED Talk. I did this in all my college classes that I teach. But ultimately, I don't look at someone and say, I think you have a bias. No, it actually comes out in this activity. So in this activity, I said a word, and I'm not going to share all of them here because of time, but I had my students private chat me one word that comes to their mind in a judge-free zone. Okay. So I had words like homeless. What's the first word that comes to your mind when you think of the word, or when you hear the word homeless or see the word homeless? The CEO of a top company, a failing student, etc. So I just had different words, and people told me the first word that came to their mind. And the point of this was to point out that we all have mental models that are constructed by our personal experiences, environment, and or parents or relationships. They're selective, they're limited. But my big question was, just because you think a certain way or think something of a word, does it make it necessarily right or true? And the answer is no. No, we all have a bias. No matter if you want to say so or not, we all have a bias. When we think of a word, when we see a word, we immediately think of blank. Does it mean that that word is right? Maybe sometimes it's right, but not in every case. And as a leader, you need to be careful of this bias, because they are not always true. Sometimes they're wrong. Sometimes they're true, but sometimes they're wrong. And finally, also talking about being culturally responsive. Not only is this a hot topic in today's day and age, but it's also the right thing to do. You need to be aware of your own culture, your own cultural norms and biases. You need to be aware of your privilege. We all have a privilege. Everyone has a privilege. You need to get to know people, your students, your members, and you need to value their culture. And you need to acknowledge that your culture isn't always better. It's just different. All right. So once again, best way to understand people is to talk to them. And you got to reflect, how does this person's culture and language and background affect their behavior? And what can I do as a leader to help them be more successful in their role? Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I know that was a lot, so you can go back anytime and take a look at what we said. But over the next three videos, I hope you join us. It's going to be on diversity and inclusion. All right. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.